By now, you know something about the objects in the scene, and you know on a general level what you can do with them. And being plucky and industrious, you're equipped to use the documentation to figure out the particulars of any given class. However, you may still be wondering how to access these objects in the first place, so let's settle that now. When you need to get to some object, you'll find it in one of two ways. You'll either use one of the free functions that allow you to find objects based on name or some other known criteria, or you'll use the FBScene class to get direct access to all of a certain type of component. Let's start with the free functions. These usually take the form FBFind something by something. For example, FBFind model by label name simply returns a model given its exact long name. More generally, there's FBFind object by full name, which will return any object if you specify its full name. In the documentation, if you go to the page for the pyfbsdk module and scroll down to functions, you'll see all the free functions listed. Confusingly, not all of these are actually exposed in Python, and there's a whole lot of garbage thrown in. If we want a more definitive list, we can get that ourselves from within MotionBuilder. All we're doing here is listing the contents of the pyfbsdk module, then printing every object whose type name indicates that it's a function. Now, this is the group of functions that we're talking about right now. And in addition to the first two, which search for and return a single object, there are another two which allow you to cast a wider net and get multiple objects. These functions, fbFindObjectsByName and fbFindObjectsByNamespace, expect to be passed an instance of fbComponentList, which they'll populate with the results. The search string can include wildcards if you want partial matches, and for fbFindObjectsByName, you're able to specify whether to search using the long name or the short name, and whether to search all components or just models. Finally, there's fbGetSelectedModels. This can be helpful when you want a script to operate on the user's selection. If you supply true for the last parameter, the list will be populated in the order in which the models were selected, with the most recently selected model at the back of the list. Here's a quick example of how we could get to the last model that the user selected, and all we're doing here is getting an ordered list of selected models, and then returning the last one. Now, all of those functions may be helpful if you know ahead of time, with complete accuracy, what an object is exclusively named. But that's usually not the case, and there's another route which can help us here, and that's the FBScene class. To access the scene object, you'll need to call FBSystem to get the global instance of the system object. FBSystem.scene gets you the scene. FBScene gives you a bunch of lists which you can use to iterate over all components of a certain type. To start with, the components list contains every component in the scene. So for example, to clear the current selection, we can just iterate over all the components in the scene and ensure that the selected property is set to false for each of them. FBScene also provides a number of categorized lists, just like the ones you see in the navigator. So for example, to iterate over all the cameras in the scene, you can use fbSystem.scene.cameras. When you start taking advantage of Python's list comprehension feature, you can filter these results pretty succinctly. Just be careful not to overdo it. Of course, there are many different lists for different types of components, and they all behave in the same way. You can find a complete listing in the documentation. Now, there's one category that works a bit differently, and that's models. Unlike all the other types of components, models are inherently part of a hierarchy. You can't simply iterate over one list and be done with it, because a model can have any number of children, which form any number of branches. So, rather than giving you a list, FBScene gives you access to the scene's root model. You can see that if we iterate over the root model's list of children, we get every top-level model in the scene. These are unique in that their parent property is none, Every other model, except for the root, is guaranteed to have another model as its parent. If you're trying to get at all the models in a particular branch, you'll probably want to use some kind of recursive function. For example, this function selects a model along with all of its descendants. Here's another example. If you delete a single model from the scene, all of its children will still be left behind. To delete an entire branch, you want to use a recursive function like this. So, to quickly review the different ways of accessing objects in the scene, if you know with absolute certainty what a model is named, you can use fbFindModelByLabelName. If it's not a model, you can use fbFindObjectByFullName and specify the group name as well. If you want all components or all models with a certain namespace or a particular pattern in their name, you can use fbFindObjectsByName or fbFindObjectsByNamespace. If you're dealing with models and you want to act on the user's selection, you can use fbGetSelectedModels. Now, if none of these cases apply, then you'll want to have a list of components so that you can examine each one individually to see if it meets whatever criteria you have. To iterate over all the components in the scene, you can use fbSystem.scene.components. If you're interested in all the models in the scene, you can start from fbSystem.scene.rootModel and traverse its children recursively. For everything else, like actors, characters, materials, groups, and so on, you'll find a specific list in FBScene to suit your needs. Well, now you know how to get to all the components in your scene, which means you can start to make them do useful things. I hope you feel empowered, and I'll see you next time.